Today we are going to study unit number 24, environmental science. So this is the topic it's necessary for us to know about, because we are in the environment. If the environment is good, then only we are survive. So it is necessary for us to maintain the environment in properly, which help us to survey us, not only as the plants and animals. So it is necessary for all to manage the environment. So regarding to this, we are going to study through this the environmental science. So introductions and biogeochemical cycle. So regarding to the environment introductions, then we move on the next topic we call is a biogeochemical cycle. So what are the objective, learning objective through these lessons? After completing these lessons, students will able to relate different aspect of environmental science. So we should know the different aspect of the environmental science. What are the aspect? So how that the living things and non-living things, how they maintain the ecosystem. So these the things we should know that. Describe biogeochemical cycle. So when you take that biogeochemical cycles, water cycles, so these are some of the example biogeochemical cycle. The nutrients or that important things is in the form of cycle. So that's also we should know that. Analyze the impact of human activities on water cycle, nitrogen cycle and carbon cycle. So this how the water cycle, nitrogen cycle and carbon cycle impact the human activities. So we should analyze. So through these lessons we are going to analyze these things. Correlate the adaptations of plants with the habitat. So adaptation is very very important. If the living organism is live in this world, because they able to adapt themselves with the environment. So because of that only they and plants or the animals able to live. So how that the adaptation is comes with their habitat where they live. So this also we are going to compare. Explain the adaptation of bat and earthworm. So bat and earthworm, how they adapt themselves with this the environment. The next one, explain recycling of water, its methods and importance. How that water recycle, how that it in the method, the water recycling, and what are the importance of the water recycle. So these are the things we are going to study in detail. Discuss the importance of water conservation and water recycling method. So it is very very important. So nowadays the scarcity of water all over the world, because one thing, the human it's not use the water properly, and water pollutions and climate change, there is no rain. So these are some of the aspect which lead the scarcity of water around the world. So it is necessary for us to reduce the usage of the water and have proper usage of the water, and we should give important for the conservation of the water. So these are the things we are going to discuss through these lessons. Nature has the power to refresh and renew. Helen Keller so say that the nature has the power to refresh and renew. So whatever it's happening, the nature has the capacity. So if you take that is a, so when you take that is a paper, so newspaper, whatever way, it will become as a waste, or the leaf become as a waste, what will happen? It recycle and becomes is the manure to the plants. So it's absorbed. So this is the one. So water, what will happen? The water is evaporated and goes to the sky and become the rain, and once again it comes to the earth. So this is the recycle. So it's nature, it's have the power to refresh and renew. or replaced by the nature. So this is the things Helland said that.
So introductions. Element of nature continuously undergo changes and transformations. So nature continuously undergo changes. So we can not only a particular process, all process it go for the continuous and transformations. So one level to another level. Environment productions provides holistic knowledge about nature process, effects of human intervention and solutions to overcome environmental problems. There are so many environmental problems because of the populations, so because of misuse of the nature, so it give the pollutions of the water or pollutions of the land or pollutions of the air. So because of the human activities is lead to that. So we how to overcome the environmental problems. So the environmental issues such as pollutions, global warming, oceans layer depletions, acid rain, deforestations, landslides, drought and desertifications have gained major focus around the world.
It is one of the very important for us to know about the global warming. So how that the global warming is become the world become worst. So how the changes is occur in this. So the global warming, it's one of the big issues which lead the global become worst. So look at this, the pictures, you come to know that it's one of the review of this, the global warming, how that changes are occur in this, the earth. One of the major, it's an increase of the carbon dioxide in earth. So it is lead to that global warming. So global warming, it's make that is the deforestations of.
So when we try to misuse that environment, so it lead to such a things we call it as the pollutions. So when you take the pollutions, there are air pollutions, water pollutions, land pollutions. It's a major pollutions. So we are disturb the environment. So we are avoid being the nature. We add something. So which is lead the pollutions of the air, which is lead to the pollutions of the water, which leads to the pollutions of the land. So this is one of the environmental problems.
Compare that is the carbon dioxide increase, so we can able to see that is through this chart. The global warming is a lead of ice. Forest fire. So these are some of the issues. So there is a scarcity of water. So these are the, so it is the called the climate changes,
global warming. So we heard that very often global warming, so it very dangerous things. We come to know something is dangerous for human being, not only human being, all living organism. Oceans layer, depletions, acid rain, deforestations. So what will happen? We are destroying the forest. So what happens? So the plant, number of the plants reduce. So the plants have the capacity to convert the carbon dioxide into oxygen. So what happens? Automatically it is renewed. So already previous slide we studied, the nature has the capacity to renew themselves. So when the carbon dioxide is increased, the plants absorb the carbon dioxide during the photosynthesis, is converted into oxygen. And is no rain and desertifications. Compare that is the carbon dioxide increase, so we can be able to see that is through this chart. The global warming is a lead of ice. Forest fire. So these are some of the issues. So there is a scarcity of water. Heavy rain, flood, and the increasing of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So these are the, so it is the called the climate changes. So these are the major focus around the world. So because of the only one, the environmental problems which causes by the human being. So look at that is one of the visible global. So because of the global warming, what will happen? The global becomes like that. So it's one side is burning, the other side is no water, something is a crack in between the land. It means it seems to be is there is no greenish, there is no plant. So this, it's not good for live. So these are some of the problem carried by the global warming. So this global warming because of us. So nature source are recycled over and over again on the earth for continued availability. So something the nature source recycle and comes again. At the same time, it is remind us of our responsibility to reduce and restrain our attitudes or activities that will affect the natural process. So it means the nature itself have the capacity to recycle and replace. But when we disturb the nature, what will happen? So it will disturb the environment. The recycle process may be disturbed because of only, so already we studied, so global warming and pollutions, deforestations and desertification. So these are the things is happening in this world. So it is our responsibility being very good to handle the natural source. Our activity should not carry harmful to the nature, or we should not use the nature for our own profit. So we have to consider the nature only give the life for us. We should not disturb the nature. If we disturb the nature react. What will happen? so we cannot able to survive. So there is a scarcity of water, or there is a water pollutions. So it is not suitable for the survival of the living organisms. So if you do good to the nature do good for us. If you do bad for the nature also replace that. So these are the things we should know, that living organism adjust themselves according to their habitat and changes in the ecosystem. The living organisms, so the those and stays, some of the organisms happening or living in this world, but now it's not no more. So what happens, the living organisms is a exchange or is a modified, or they adapt themselves according to the ecosystem. Ecosystem means is nothing, the where the living organism adapted to the non-living organisms. For example, we are the human being, we cannot say that we don't like the non-living organism. It means I don't want oxygen. So oxygen is considered as a non-living organism. Can you able to live? No. Without oxygen, we cannot live. So like that. So adaptations, the ecosystem should be is a come together living organism and between non-living organism. So that is the mutual relations. That only is a help. So all living organisms developed such a morphological. Morphological means that the external appearance, anatomical. So the internal structure of the human or internal structure of the air, whatever may be, physiological. And reproductive adaptations which help themselves to survive better and to withstand and the environmental conditions. So this is adaptation is very very important, because the adaptation is not, or the living organism not to adapt themselves with the environment or with the ecosystem, the survival of the living organism is no more. So this is very important for us. That's the way we are going to study through these lessons. We should keep the environment in properly. We have to use the environment in properly, or we have to use the natural things in properly. We should not misuse the nature. So these lessons deals with the biogeochemical cycle, adaptations by the plants and animals, water conservations and recycle of water. So these are the things we are going to study. So these lessons, so we are going to study about biogeochemical cycle. So when you go for is a biogeochemical cycle, water cycle, nitrogen cycle, ammonium cycle, whatever may be. So this we call as a biogeochemical cycle. Adaptations. So all the living organism able to adapt themselves. So look at the plants. All the plants not able to live in our area. Only a certain plants able to live. It means they plants adapt themselves according to the situations, adapt to the climate which around in our area. For example, we cannot cultivate the apple tree, but we every day we like to eat apple, but we cannot able to cultivate because the apple tree have proper environment which cannot provide in our area. That's the way they are not able to live in around us. So adaptation is very very important. So these are the things we have to recycle of water. So recycle of water, when you go study water evaporated and goes to the sky, then it becomes as a rain, then once again it comes to the earth. So it is like a water cycle. So these are the things we are going to study in detail. Biogeochemical cycle. Bio means life. Geo is earth. Biosphere is the part of the earth where life exists. So when you take the earth, there are two. One is non-living things, another one is the living things. Non-living things is also important and living things also important. Living things always depend on the non-living things. But non-living things not depend on the living things. So if the living things want to survive in this world, they want to depend on the non-living things. The non-living things should be maintained. So all the source of the biosphere can be grouped into two major categories. So it will, when you take the biosphere, so it is maintained by the two categories. What are they? Biotic are living factors, which include plants, animals, and all other living organisms. Living organisms, plants, all the plants, all animals, all living organisms. It may be a unicellular organism or multicellular organism. Unicellular organism also considered as a biotic factors or living factors. And multiple organism also is considered as biotic factors. So these are biotic factor organism. All plants, animals, and all living organism considered as biotic factors. Abiotic factor are non-living factors which include all factors like temperature, pressure, water, soil, air, and sunlight, which affect the ability of organism to survive and reproduce. So already told that the temperature is very very important. So the temperature is not equal all over the world. Some area it's very cool conditions, some area it's very hot conditions. The pressure also is not similar to all over the world. So it will be variated. The water contained, the minerals also is variated. Fresh water, salt water. So like that. Soil, the soil condition also is different. The nutrition which is present in soil is different. Air, sunlight, and these are the affecting ability to organism. These are not in the good conditions. The adaptation is not good for the all living organism. So the living organism adapt according to that the availability of the nutrition which is present around the ecosystem. So if the organism want to survive, the adaptation is very very important. The environment also is very very important. So the environmental is very good means the adaptation should be is very suitable for living organism. So according to that adaptation, the living organism is spread all over the world. So plants, animals, and has all living organism abiotic and living organism factor, which is include factors like temperature, pressures, those. So this is the things. So we should know that the ability so organism to survive. There is a constant interactions between biotic and abiotic components in the biosphere. So when you take this as biosphere, the biosphere consists of the living organism and non-living organisms, and that make the biosphere and dynamic and stable system. So it should be a dynamics as well as stable. Cycling flows of nutrition between non-living and living factors of the environment are termed as biogeochemical cycle. Some of important biogeo cycles are water cycle, nitrogen cycle, carbon cycle. So these are the three cycles we are going to study next class. So these three, so we consider as a biogeochemical cycle, water cycle, how that water evaporator, how the nitrogen is comes atmospheric nitrogen comes to that earth, how that is absorbed the plants, so how becomes the atmospheric nitrogen. So these are the things we are going to study that. So very simple things we should know, that is there in this world there are two organisms. One is a non-living organism, another one is a living organism. Non-living organisms, that air temperature, pressure, so these all we call is a non-living organism. Plants and animals and all living organism we call is a living organism, unicellular organism to multicellular organisms. So both are is adapt, their living organism adapt to the non-living organisms. So how that is maintained? Because the nature has the power to replace or refresh or renew if the environment being is as it is. When we are disturbed, what will happen? So it lead to the global warming and scarcity of water or acid rain or desertifications. So these are the things is happening in this world. We should know that. So next class we will study the water cycle. Thank you.